chapter, I will be reading from the verses. Isaiah, which is almost in the middle of the book. Start with Psalms and go to the right. Chapter 43, from the verses of 1, verses 1 through 2. We all have to say amen.
Amen.
Amen, amen. And read as follows. But now this says the Lord to you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by your name. God knew your name. You are mine. Everybody say, I'm God's. I'm God's. So who the Lord loveth, he chases. So if you all know that God got your back. Okay, I'm going to preach on now, okay? And look, I want y'all to say that again now. Verse 5, through the water, I will be with you. It's not if, it's when. So it is a when. Everybody has a when. When you pass through the water, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you should not be burned, nor should the flames scorch you. You all can see. Father God, I thank you today. I praise you today. I worship you today. I lift your name up today. I give your name all the praises. I give your name all the glory. I give your name all the honor. Let me decrease in you. You increase in you. You will get all the praises, all the glory, and all the honor. You are the author of the book of Isaiah, Father God. So you know everything that needs to be said. How I need to teach you, Father God. So take me out of the way, Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name, I pray that the people who truly love God of today say amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
For the next half an hour or so, I'd like to teach on a subject called Before God Can Take You to It, He Must First Bring You Through It.
Come on.
We need to understand something. Before God can take you to it, He must first bring you through it.
Yes.
Many times in life, We like what you call microwave Christians. Everybody wants something. I need God's blessings now. I need to fulfill my calling now. I need to do this now. I want my relationship with my husband or my wife to be now. I want the relationship with my mom and my father and my cousin. We want God to go down. We want everything to be done now. But before God can take you to it, He must first bring you through it. We need to understand by reading passage scripture that everybody, it is going to be a win. It's not an if, it's going to be a win. We are not exempt from life adversities just because we are Christians. As a matter of fact, if you are a Christian, then you are subject, you are going to go through some things. That's what God said that, what? Before, when I bring you through the water, I will be with you. When you go through the river, it will not overflow you, which means that some of us will be in some deep water in life. And when you go to the river, when you go through the fire, we all know the fire is a firm what? Is a kind of purgement.
Yes.
Gold is not what? Try, it's not clarified as what? Pure gold continues to try. So you're going to go through some things in life. We need to understand there's no escaping life adversity. As Christians, we are going to go through it. We want just God just to give us our destiny. Lord, give me this, give me that, just give it to me. Lord, give it to me. Without paying the price. It is a price we have to pay as Christians. I know some of us want our relationship. I know some of us want the job, and we want this now because we've been going through a whole lot of things in life. I know we want it now. But it is a process we have to go through. See, we can't see. You can pray God's will for your life, but you can't pray God's timing. We need to understand that God is a God of timing. God is a God of everything about God flows in time. We understand. The Greek word for time is what? Chronos. We all know chronos. Chronos means what? Second equal minute, meter equal hour, hour equal years, an hour. It's the time we go by in life. It's chronos time. Chronos. But then, within chronos, God has a specific time right when God want to bring you out, when God want to bless you, when God want to take you and elevate you. It's called kairos. Kairos is a specific time that lies within chronos when God is ready to bless you. But before God can take you to it, He must first bring you through it. And God is going to bring you through it. See, we want to jump from A to get to Z. But where B, C, D, E, F, G, we have to what? See, we can't just go over. We want to just jump over without going through it.
Come on.
You don't go through it, y'all. You can't get from A to D. You have what, B and C. What about B and C? And that's why I mentioned that we have different forms of chapters in our lives. We need to understand that Jesus is the author and the finisher of our faith. So the author and finisher of our faith, right, know the beginning and know the end.
Yes.
So we need to let Jesus be the author and the finisher of our faith. So if Jesus wrote the book, then Jesus knows everything that's in the book. So we can't skip chapters. See, some of y'all giving them chapter 2 when your blessing is going to come in chapter 5.
Come on, come on, come on.
Just make it chapter 5. Your blessing is in chapter 5. But now, you will go through all hell and water in 2, 3, and 4. So we want to skip 1 and get to 5, but God say, no, before I can take you through it, I must first bring you through it.
Come on, Pastor.
We need to understand you have to experience it. You have to experience it. How do you know? See, I remember, I talked about this earlier. The Bible said that God came to Adam and said, Adam, where are thou? It's not that God did not know where Adam was at. Because we all know the word God is omniscient. God everything. He know everything. So God know everything. So he said, Adam, where are thou? It was not like God did not know where Adam. God was someone asking what you call a rhetorical question. He wanted Adam to know where you at. He said, Adam, do you really know where you at? And that's how it is with us, right? God has to take us through a lot of situations in life so we can be able to find out where we at.
Come on.
Because some of us don't know where we at. How many of y'all say y'all love God? How many hands gonna get, right? How many of y'all love God? The only way to prove that you love God is to know it. You know what? God is going to allow me to be in a situation to show you. Okay, so you say you love me, Paul. So see, you say you love me, Brother Blake. Okay, you know what? You are about to be put in a situation that is going to show if you love me or not. God is going to put you in a situation because the only way to show, right? The only way God is, the only way you will ever be able to show God you love him, you have to go through it. And you have to go through it and say, you know what? For Jesus I live, for Jesus I die. And that's why I'm going to share right and the go. God could have delivered them out of it, but God allowed them to go up through it. Oh, y'all missed that now.
Yes.
God had the power and ability, right, to keep them from what?
Burning.
Going to the fire. God could have stopped and said, no. God said, no, you are going to go through the fire, but I will be with you.
Yes.
And I know that God will be with you. He will be right there with you in the midst of your situation and your circumstance. Y'all need to understand that. And not only that, they came out pure. Not even, they was not even smelling like.
Come on.
They was in the fire. And I know it's easy said than done. Because when you're going through it, it's hard to see where God has predestined you to be. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, how many of y'all, you watching football and basketball from the TV, right? Right? Y'all can see everything, right? But the people who have actually played the game, they can't see it. Because it's something about when you're in it, right? You can't see nothing else. So I know people come to you and say, girl, God loves you. Girl, you know what? He gonna bring you in. I don't want to hear that because what I'm in it, you're not in it. So it's kind of hard to receive it from people because you ain't going through what I'm going through, right? You have not experienced what I'm experiencing right now. So I understand what you're trying to say, and everything you're saying is good, but until you have been in my shoes, you can't talk about it.
Come on, come on.
And that's how it is in life. People want to tell you about your business, and this and that, but you have not experienced it. You have not experienced what I'm going through. But God is there with you. And you have to go through it, y'all. I don't care what the situation and circumstances may be. If God loves you and God will see you through. But it does not mean that you're not going to get burned. It does not mean that you ain't going to suffer from it. Because everybody is going to pay the price as a Christian. We are not exempt. When Jesus came to earth, right, Jesus did not just jump past Calvary. Jesus was in the garden and he said, Father, let this go past me. Jesus tried to jump over it. As a man, he was right. Right, as a man. Then Jesus said, nevertheless, not my will, but I will be done. Jesus had this man's Calvary.
Yes.
Then he was crowned King of Kings and Lord of Lords. But he had to experience Calvary. It was not jumping over. He had to go through the cross. He had to get beaten. He had to get talked about, spit on. He had to go through the process. So if Jesus had to go through the process, who are you?
Come on. Come on.
If you want God to take you to it, you have to go through it. You have to trust him. There are going to be times when it seems like God is not there. Joseph was in prison over 10 years. Over 10 years for a crime he did not commit. But it was in all God's plan. Joseph ended up being second in charge of Egypt, but he had to go through it. He had to go through 10, 11 years of hell, but God was with him. He had to go through it. tell you that. God has a calling for everybody in here. God has a calling for everybody in here. God did not make no mistake when he created you. You are a king's kid, royal priest, a chosen generation. That's why they say that you are mine. Read this verse. Let's read it again. Verse 1 says that I have called you by my name. You are mine. So anytime, if you gave your life to Jesus, you are God, you are king's kid, you are royal, what, priest of a chosen generation, you are not what you have become. I don't care how you live, if you are God's child, you are not what you have become. Yeah, you might be out there doing things you are what, not supposed to be doing, but it don't stop you being God, a king's kid, royal priest of a chosen generation. The prodigal son was far off. And the Bible said that he said he came to himself, he recognized what he was warranted. But he had to go through it. God loves you all.
Amen.
I know some of y'all want y'all situation to be over with instantly. It does not happen like that. This is not a microwave society. God does not work in a microwave atmosphere. I'm telling you, anytime, listen, I was talking today. I was telling people that. How many of y'all want patience? Did a couple of you raise a hand? A couple of you said, I want no patience. Because we need to understand. In order to have patience,
you
have to go through it. You have to go through it. And I said it before, patience and twins. Well, patience and faith is twin. Show me a man have faith, I show you a man have patience. Show me a man have patience, I show you a man have faith. You can't have one without the other one. It takes two of them. Patience is a bridge that faith sits on. Oh, y'all need to catch on to this. Patience is the bridge that your faith sits on. When your patience crumbles, your faith crumbles. Faith needs some form of support to be able to what? Stand on.
Amen.
So when you begin to want patience in life, you have to go through it. You can't go around it. Some of us try to run from the process. Some of us try to run from the process, right? I see people say, Pastor, lay hands on someone's life to be all right. Okay, I can lay hands on you, but you still have to go through it. Pastor, I'm looking at a big time job. You try to put on yet? You do this? No, I'm trying to say that. No. People need to understand something, right? People want everything to be so quick, but you have to pay the price for it. It is a price you have to pay. It is a price you have to pay. Ain't no getting around it.
Yeah.
Pastor, I want this in life. Pastor, I want to be delivered. I want to do this. You have to do your part. Before God can take you to it, you must first go through it. I don't know what you're going through. Some of y'all have already set your mind out what y'all want to be in life. But like I said earlier, that God takes you to different stages in life. He takes you through stages. You have to go to first grade, go to second grade, go to third grade. We can't pick and choose what stage we don't want to be in life.
Come on.
We can't pick and choose where we want to be in life. You gave your life to Jesus. He's the author and finisher of your faith. He knows all about your life. We need to keep that in mind. He knows everything about your life. Some of us has already set our agenda of what we want to be in life. Is that what God wants you to be in life?
Come on.
Know something. The anointing of God only follows the will of God.
Come on.
Y'all need to understand this. The anointing of God only follows the will of God. So, if you're not in God's will, the anointing does not supply your needs in that area because God's anointing only follows his will. So some of us are doing our own thing and wonder why we're trying to figure out and wondering why we are not prospering because we are God's will. And God's will only follows his will. God's anointing only follows his will.
Amen.
We need to keep that in mind. So if you're going through your situation and it's something that you brought upon yourself, right? Now, what happened is that the mercy of God will sustain you. Even though you might have been messed up and doing things you're not supposed to do right, that's where God's mercy comes now. But the favor of God takes you to the next level. So if you're not in God's will, right, God's mercy will compass you, but his favor is not there because what mercy sustains, but favor takes you to the next level.
Amen. Good stuff.
So some of y'all, even though y'all appear to y'all being blessed and all that kind of stuff, and you stagnated in life because you have not went through it, right? You're trying to do what? Create your your own scenarios, right, of how you get it right without going God's way. You're trying to put people, place, and things right, trying to do everything you can as a way, right, to get around it. And wonder why it ain't going nowhere. Because it's either God's way or no way. God is not going to compromise his will to fit your agenda. You can cry, you can fast, you can pray, you can do everything you want to do. But it's going to come back around till you have to go through it. Because God is not going to take you to it unless you go through it. Some of y'all might have to go through a lot of headaches and pains and this and that in life. Yes, I know we don't want to experience that, right? I know we want to, but you know, we don't want to experience crying and pain and being alone. And you know what? In the midst of you going through it, sometimes you're going to be alone. You might be all by yourself. It might appear that nobody else is with you. But we need to understand something. That's why some of us do not want to go, what, let go of that relationship, because what, we don't want to be by ourselves. Because we know what God is telling us to do. We know God is telling us to let go. And we don't want to do it because we don't want to experience that. But then you all, same one, say what? God, I want to be this for you. I want to do this. I want to be this great giant, this great man of God, this great woman of God. Like God said, all that is good. But you have to allow me to take you through it. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you all. How many of y'all ready to go? How many of y'all ready for God to take y'all to? Oh, come on. Oh.
I want to go too.
I didn't know ahead. Let me speak English. I guess I was speaking Spanish. How many of you all want God to take you to it?
Yes.
Are y'all?
Amen.
The devil is alive. If God can take you to it, he will give you the grace to go to it. Now let me say this again. Come on, y'all, let the devil scare y'all like that. Some of y'all just don't want to let go. Y'all holding on to it. I'm going to say it again in English. How many of you all who is present here today at Kingdom Way of Living Ministry want God to take you to it?
Yes.
Everybody, yes. How many of y'all have y'all eat? How many of y'all know where y'all want to be at?
Amen.
Now, another question becomes, how many of y'all are ready to go through?
Yes, yes.
You know what? It's like to say you ain't ready to go through it. Like, I ain't ready to go through it. But you still have to go through it. Nobody want to go through it. But I promise you, I can say this as I close. You will never get God's best in your life if you don't go through it. You are not exempt. I don't care what you say you love God. I don't care about your tithe and your offering. I don't care how much you come to church. I don't care if you're a deacon. I don't care if you're a pastor. I don't care who you are, your status in life. Everybody has to go through it. Amen.
Amen.
May God bless y'all.